Recently, the five bishops of the dioceses of Wisconsin, including the Archdiocese of Milwaukee and of course Madison, made the joint decision to lift the suspension of the Mass, Sunday Mass obligation during this month of September. So here in the Diocese of Madison, beginning the weekend of September 26th, 27th, the Sunday Mass obligation will once again be in effect. That obligation is there in the first place to remind us that for us as Catholics, Mass is central. Mass is essential. Mass is everything for us. That in the Mass, we hear God's word proclaimed to us. We lay our prayers, our gifts, our works on the altar in the form of the bread and wine. We share in the perpetual offering of the Son to the Father through the Paschal mystery of Jesus' death and resurrection. And we receive the body of Christ, the living, sacramental, actual presence of Jesus in physical form into our bodies and into our hearts and souls. That Mass is for us as Catholics what breathing is for us as human beings, that the Eucharist is to our soul what eating is for our bodies, that we cannot live without the Eucharist. It was back on March 17th that I made the difficult decision to suspend the Mass obligation because we were in those first early weeks of the COVID pandemic and there was so much uncertainty and so much not known. And that suspension has remained in effect for the past 6 months. At the end of May, beginning with Pentecost Sunday, we began a gradual opening up of Mass once again for public celebration. And with many safety precautions in effect, to my knowledge, no one in our diocese has gotten sick or had a fatality because of catching COVID at Mass. So I just want to commend our priests, our leaders, and our people overall. I think we've been trying to be careful and prudent in regards to having public Masses celebrated in our parishes throughout the diocese, and that will continue. We're at a different point now. We're at a point where younger people who are healthy and don't have immune deficiency or are not in regular contact with elderly people or people that are vulnerable can safely be coming back to Mass again if we're prudent and careful. And so at the end of this month, once again, the obligation will be restored. What that doesn't mean is that anyone who is elderly, who is ill, who has an immune deficiency, who has a health vulnerability, or someone that takes care of folks in those qualities or lives with people that are vulnerable, those folks still have an exemption. You know, there's things in canon law that rightfully lift the Sunday Mass obligation. If you literally cannot find a Mass to go to, say if you're traveling, or if you're ill with the flu and you stay at home, or if you're simply required to work and there's just no possibility for you to go to Mass. Those are legitimate reasons to miss Mass on Sunday. So those exemptions are in place for those who are still vulnerable, those who are elderly, those who are at risk. So in reinstituting the Sunday Mass obligation, it isn't this draconian demand that everyone come back to Mass regardless of their health or their physical condition. But it's really reinstituting the normalcy of saying Sunday Mass is essential for us. And if I have no compelling reason not to go, I need to be at Sunday Mass. I need that spiritual strength and blessing and grace that comes to us when we receive the Eucharist, when we attend Mass in person. Watching Mass online and making a spiritual communion are pious practices, necessary and good during these months of COVID pandemic, but they don't substitute for the actuality of sacrament. It's the same reason that we can't hear confessions over the phone. You need to be there in person. Sacraments are not virtual, because God is not virtual. There's a reality to the sacrament because there's a direct relationality between us and God. And the power of the Eucharist makes all of that palpable and real. So I encourage those who can to start coming back to Mass. I encourage those who shouldn't be coming to still make Sunday a day of prayer and praise, reading the Bible, doing the readings, praying the rosary, practicing some form of spiritual devotion or charity. In all those ways, we can sanctify Sunday even if we're not present at Mass. So we praise the Lord Jesus for the gift of the Eucharist. I thank the Lord for the priests that we have who make the Eucharist of Christ present for us, and just for the fidelity and perseverance of our people and patience in all of these months of challenge and trial and struggle. The Mass holds us together as a church. The Mass will nurture us as followers of Christ.